In January, on the heels of Donald Trump's second year in office, shortly after Elon Musk had been fined $20 million and Kevin Hart's Oscar hosting gig had been canceled because of controversial tweets, and weeks following Twitter CEO Jack Dorsey's return from a 10-day silent meditation trip to Myanmar, about which he praised the food and the beauty of the monasteries but neglected to mention the ongoing regional genocide, Twitter made it clear that some things were about to change. Just not the tweets. Though the company had spent the better part of the year promoting healthy conversations, it wasn't much interested in putting the screws on its users. Debates, disagreements, the occasional blowout controversy, that was all stuff that made Twitter Twitter. No, instead, Twitter decided to change itself from the outside in. It was time to give the experience of using Twitter a makeover. A redesign of Twitter's website was long overdue. The desktop interface hadn't been refreshed in 7 years, and the technology stack was so old that it was hard for the engineering team to issue any improvements. The team had begun fiddling with a web redesign back in 2017, and opened it up to beta testing in September 2018. By January, it was time to show more users how the new Twitter would look. But as soon as Twitter invited people to opt into a prototype of the new design, a new Twitter.com was coming. The peanut gallery began to weigh in, and not altogether kindly. What could Twitter do to improve its web design? Delete it. Edit button. All we want is an edit button. Did you get rid of the Nazis? Looks ugly, one user offered, perhaps charitably, but I don't think it's a big deal. For Twitter's design team, none of this was surprising. We used to launch a feature and then search for it and put up a projector of the tweets coming in, says Biz Stone, Twitter's co-founder, who rejoined the company 2 years ago. We'd be like, champagne? And then it would be like, oh. Maybe we shouldn't. So for the desktop redesign, Twitter's design team chose to proceed with caution. The preview back in January was just a heads up. A small percentage of Twitter users could opt into a series of design experiments, but nothing was final, feedback was welcome, and no one had a new design foisted upon them. And those experiments? Nothing explosive. Twitter just wanted to see how its users would interact with bookmarks, or dark mode, or a search bar that had been moved to a different spot on the page.